Hello students, welcome to AIIMS India online classes. This is a chemistry session. In this we are discussing about the chapter matter around us. In this session we are going to see practice sheet related to this chapter. So before going to see the practice sheet, let us have a glance on the concepts which we have learned from this chapter. We studied that matter is classified into 5 states. They are solids, liquids, gases, plasma and Bose-Einstein state. Bose-Einstein condensate or BEC is called. Now see here, different properties of each and every state of matter are explained here, and we can see clearly how this matter can be converted from one form to another form by changing heat also, temperature also. When we change the temperature, matter changes from one form to another form. If you see solids, they are rigid, they have fixed shape, they have fixed volume also, they are least compressible, their molecules are having high force of attraction, molecular distances are very less. And when you heat these solids, they convert into liquid. That process is called melting. And these liquids are having fixed volume but no fixed shape. These are a little compressible, difficult to compress, and very little they compress. Compressibility a little greater than the sort of solids, but very less it is. And molecular attractions are somewhat less when compared to solids, and molecular distances are greater than that of solids. They have fixed volume, but they do not have fixed shape. Liquids take the shape of the container in which they are stored. Examples for the liquids are milk, water, oils, and these all we can say. And when these liquids are heated, they start converting into gases form. That process is called evaporation or boiling. So these gases are having no fixed shape, no fixed volume. They have very low density. Molecules are having very less force of attraction among them, and the molecular distances are very high when compared to solids and liquids, and they do not have fixed volume or shape, and they fill the container in which they are stored. So they take the shape of the container just like the liquids. These gases are highly compressible. They can be compressed to very high extent. Example for these gases are air, hydrogen examples. Oxygen, nitrogen, these all also will come under. Now, fourth state of matter, plasma. This is a excited particles state in which gas molecules are ionized to form positive ions and negative electrons. And this is contained in fluorescent lights, aurora, and even stars like sun, and these all they contain this plasma. And the fifth state of matter is Bose-Einstein condensate, BEC. It is obtained when gases are cooled to very low temperatures, which are near to absolute zero, nothing but zero kelvins or -273 degrees Celsius temperature. At this temperature, BEC is obtained. So here you can see different other conversions also. Solids convert into liquids. That process is called melting. Liquids can be converted into solids by the process called freezing. Liquids can be converted into gases by the process called evaporation or boiling. Again, in the reverse way, gases can be converted into solids by the process called condensation. Often, some solids, they directly convert into gaseous state. That is called sublimation. Okay, based upon these all concepts, we are going to have this practice sheet. In this practice sheet, there will be different kinds of questioning, like single correct answer type questions, multi correct answer type questions, comparison paragraph, matrix matching, and different kinds like analytical questions. These all will be there. First, let us see single correct answer type questions. In this, objective questions will be with one correct answer. So read the question carefully and answer them. Try to answer them. See the first one. Intermolecular force of attraction is maximum in. See, different substance states of matter are present here. In which of these, molecular force of attraction is maximum? in which it will be, yes, we know, solids. Solids are having intermolecular force of attraction maximum. That is why only molecules are tightly packed in these solids. Okay, solids are having intermolecular force of attraction maximum. Next, which of the following has no fixed volume and no fixed shape? So, in which state of matter it is having no fixed volume, no fixed shape? Yes, in the gaseous state. Gases do not have fixed volume or shape. They fill the container in which they are filled. They are stored. Okay, identify the gaseous component among these four. So, that will be having no fixed volume or no fixed shape. What kind of matter is this book? Book is a solid. What about brick? Book or brick? These all will come under solids. And if you see oxygen, oxygen is a gas. What about milk? Milk is a liquid. Now, among these all, oxygen is a gas which do not have fixed volume or shape. So, it is correct answer. Next one. The temperature at which the solid melts to become a liquid at atmospheric pressure is called. What is the process? What is the temperature? The temperature at which solid converts into liquid. That we say the conversion of solid into liquid is called melting. The temperature at which this melting occurs is called melting point. For example, if you take ice converts into liquid water at a temperature 0 degree Celsius. So, this 0 degree Celsius is called the melting point of ice. Melting point means the temperature at which a solid starts converting into liquid. Next one. Solids have dash shape and dash volume. What about the shape and volume of solids? They have definite shape and definite volume. Yes, they have fixed shape and fixed volume. This is correct. Next one. The decreasing order of densities of solids, liquids and gases for a given mass is. Decreasing order of densities, they are asking. We know solids are having maximum density and gases are having least density. Now see which is the correct order. So, they are asking to arrange them in the decreasing order. So, first we have to write the state which is having maximum density. And at last it should be the state of matter with least density. See, solids are having maximum density. So, solids should be at the starting. And gases are having the least. So, that should be at the last. In which it is? Yes, the fourth one. Solid density is highest and gases are having lower densities. Okay, next one. Which of the following is accompanied by cooling? Yes, which of these processes cause cooling, they are asking. See, boiling actually it is caused by taking energy, means by heating only. Even condensation. Condensation is but release of energy. Only evaporation occurs by cooling. If you take any volatile liquid into your hand, volatile liquid means which evaporates it below its melting point. So, if you take any liquid into your hand, when it evaporates, it makes the surroundings cool. So, evaporation is accompanied by cooling. Next one. The movement of air or vapors of scent and smoke is known as. Yes, the movement of air or vapors of scent, smoke. These all, the movement of these all is called diffusion. Or the spreading property of gases is called diffusion. In the other way also you can say, the intermixing property of these gases is called diffusion property. Diffusion means movement of gases from one place to another place. Or also can be said, the intermixing of these all different gases one into another is called diffusion. The interparticle distances are least in. So, in which state of matter particles are very closely packed? In that state, the interparticle distances are least. What does it mean by interparticle distances? The distance between the adjacent particles in a matter is called interparticle distance. So, this will be least in solid state. Because in solids, particles are very tightly packed. They are very close one another. So, the distance between them will be very less, very least. Okay. Next, the property of compressibility is. What about this compressibility property? If you see in solids, already molecules are very tightly packed. So, the compressibility is highly impossible. The highly difficult it is. So, compressibility is least in solids. Whereas, if you see in gases, interparticles are very loosely packed. They are very far away from one another. So, they can be compressed very easily. We can say compressibility is highest or maximum in gases. So, compressibility is least in solids, maximum in gases. See, out of these two statements which is given here now, compressibility is least in solids. This is correct. Okay, least in solids, maximum in gases. The state of matter which consists of superenergetic particles in the form of ionized gases is called, what it is called? Plasma state. When gases are heated to very high temperatures, the molecules of these gases will be ionized into positive ions and negative electrons. That superenergetic state is called plasma state. Okay, fourth state of matter, plasma. Which is not an example of matter? See the options once given. Which is not related to matter form? Milk is a liquid matter. Water also a liquid matter. We see gas is a gaseous matter. But if you see the second option, sound. Sound is not a form of matter. It is a form of energy. Sound comes under energy form. Sound, light, heat, magnetism, electricity, these all come under forms of energy. It won't come under matter. Okay, it is not a matter. Next one. The conversion of gas into liquid is called. The conversion of gas into liquid. What do we call this? Conversion of a gas into liquid by cooling is called condensation. Condensation. Okay, next one. 300 ml of oxygen is collected at a pressure of 380 mm of mercury. What volume will this gas have at 1 atmosphere pressure? So, they have given a problem, calculational problem. Now, first let us see the data given in this. 300 ml of oxygen is collected at a pressure of 380 mm of mercury. What are these two quantities? You see 300 ml of oxygen. What does it represent? Volume of oxygen initially. So let us consider this as initial volume of oxygen. At this volume is at a pressure of 380 mm of mercury. So this is a pressure of the oxygen gas initial. So let us consider this as initial pressure. Now they are asking what will be the volume of this gas at 1 atmosphere pressure. This 1 atmosphere pressure is nothing but final pressure, we let us consider. This is final pressure. Now, they are asking to find out the volume of oxygen at this final pressure. So, they are asking to find out final volume. Initial pressure and initial volume are given. Final pressure is given. Asking to find out final volume. See, between these, pressure and volume, we have a relation from the law called Boyle's law. So, first to find out the final volume. In this whatever the problematic question given like this, first habituate to write the given data. Let us try to see that. See the given data. Initial volume V1 is equal to 300 ml. Initial pressure P1 is equal to 380 ml. Final volume they are asking to calculate. We have to find it. Final pressure is given 1 atmosphere. Nothing but 760 mm of Hg. Okay. Now we have to find out V2 or final volume. From the Boyle's law, we have P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Boyle's law equation it is called. So in this, we know initial pressure, initial volume, final pressure also we know. Only we have to find out final volume. Keep this as subject, we get it as V2 is equal to P1 V1 by P2. If you substitute these all values, we get 150 ml. The final volume of the gas will be 150 ml. Here it is in the second option. So it will be correct answer now. Okay, did you get? If it is given any problem like this, first be habituated to write the given data. So from the data given in the question, we can identify what to be found. What are the given values? What is the value to be found? By observing this all, we can understand the formula which we have to use there. So if you observe here, pressure and volume relation is given. So pressure and volume relation is obtained from the Boyle's law and Boyle's law equation. P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So out of these four variables, three are given. The fourth one we have to find out. Okay, it is the final volume of the oxygen gas at 1 atmosphere is 150 ml. I think you observed pressure increased so that volume is decreased. We know from the Boyle's law, pressure and volume are inversely proportional one to another at constant temperature. As pressure increased here, volume of the gas reduced to half. Okay, let us see next. Multi-correct answer type questions. Here, there will be objective question, but here, there might be one or more than one correct answers for each question. So try to understand, read the question, observe all the correct answers, identify all the correct options. See the first one. Which of the following elements have definite volume but no shape? Definite volume but no shape. In which state of matter they are containing fixed volume but no shape? In liquid state. So in liquid state, matter or the substances, they will be having definite volume but no shape. They will take the shape of the container in liquid state. See, out of these four which are coming under liquids, they will be having definite volume but no shape. What about mercury? Mercury is a liquid. It is a liquid metal, we know. So it will be having definite volume but no shape. What about iron? It is a solid. So it will be having fixed volume, fixed shape. Tin is also a solid. So it also will be having fixed volume as well as fixed shape. What about bromine? Bromine is also a liquid. So it also will be having definite volume but no shape. Now, bromine and mercury are liquids. So they do not have any fixed shape, but they have definite volume. Next, choose the correct statement from the given. See the first statement, solids do not diffuse. Yes, diffusion means intermixing one into another easily, spreading property. So liquids, solids, they cannot diffuse. It is correct statement. The density of liquids is relatively less than that of solids. Yes, density of solids is maximum when compared to the liquids and solid gases. So liquids have less density relatively than that of solids. So it is also correct statement. Gases exert pressure in all directions, isn't it? Yes, gases exert pressure in all directions. That's correct. Next one, solids cannot be compressed. Yes, in solids already particles are very tightly packed one into another. So they cannot be compressed at all. So this is also correct statement. Now what will be correct answer? All of these. All the statements are correct. Next one. As a solid melts to form liquid. What happens when a solid melts to form liquid? interparticle force of attraction decreases, because in solids attraction is very high. When it converts to liquid, liquids are having less attractions than that of solids. So interparticle force of attraction decreases, not increases. Compressibility increases. Yes, it is correct, because solids are least compressible, whereas the liquids are a little compressible than when compared to solids. So it is correct. The energy of the particles increases. It is also correct, because to convert a solid into liquid, we should heat it. So heat is given to the particles while converting into liquids. So particles are having more energy in liquid state than that in the solid state. Now, volume increases. Of course, in general, solids having less volume than that of liquids. So liquids will have more, greater volume than that of solids. So this is also correct. What will be correct answer? These three. Next, which of the following substances are sublimable solids? What does it mean here? The sublimable solids mean sublimation. We have studied sublimation means the conversion of solids directly into gaseous form without coming into liquid state is called sublimation. So those substances which convert directly from solid state to gaseous state are called sublimable solids. Example, iodine, camphor, ammonium chloride, naphthalene, these all will come under sublimable solids, because when you heat these all, they directly convert from solid state to gaseous state. They will be converted directly into gaseous state without coming into liquid state. So these are called sublimable solids, and that process or phenomenon is called sublimation. Okay. Next type of questions, combination paragraph. Let us see the paragraph given or passage given. Observe different types of matter around you. What are its different states? We can see that matter around us exists in three different states majorly. Yes, what are those? Solids, liquids and gases. These states of matter arise due to the variation in the characteristics of the particles of matter. Yes, based upon the variation in the particles of matter, these three states of matter are occurring. Okay, now based upon these, let us see questions. First among them, solids are, what are solids? Are they non-compressible? Are they compressible? Are they rigid? What is the correct answer? Yes, solids are non-compressible. We cannot compress them because already they are tightly packed and they are rigid also. They have fixed shapes. Now, these two are correct. Both A and C is correct. D is correct option now. Okay, let's go to the next one. The quantity of matter, whatever the state of matter, the quantity will be always fixed. If you change the shape, if you change the matter, if you change the state, so that may occur. But matter quantity will be always fixed. Quantity is but mass. Its mass will be fixed. Whatever the state of the matter, its quantity or mass will be fixed always. So it is constant. For example, if you take 1 kg of ice, that means 1 kg of solid, if you heat it, it converts into liquid form. So even after converting into liquid state also, its mass will be 1 kg only, it won't be changed. If you convert this 1 liter of water into 1 kg of water into gas, then also if you calculate the weight of the total vapor form, that also will be 1 kg only. That means the quantity won't be changed for a matter even though it changes its states. Okay, it is fixed. Next one. What is the physical state of water at room temperature? What does it mean here, room temperature? Room temperature is normal temperature, which is commonly taken as 25 degrees Celsius temperature. Is 25 degrees Celsius temperature considered as room temperature? What is the state of water at this 25 degrees Celsius? Yes, it is liquid state. We know below 0 degrees Celsius, water exists in the solid state, that is ice form. In between 0 degrees and 100 degrees Celsius temperature, water exists in the liquid state, that is water form. If you increase the temperature above 100 degrees Celsius, then water exists in the gaseous form, in the form of water vapor or steam. Okay, but in between 0 and 100 degrees Celsius, water exists in the liquid state. At 25 degrees Celsius also, it will be in the liquid form. Next, matrix matching type. Here, the conversion in the column 1 will be given. It's the correct definition in the column 2. Try to match this. What is it called? The conversion of solid into liquid. What we call solid conversion into liquid? We call it as melting. Conversion of a solid into liquid is called melting. The conversion of solid into gas, it is a special process we told already. The conversion of a solid directly into gas without converting into liquid state is called sublimation. Yes, it is sublimation. Next one, gas to liquid. The conversion of gas into liquid is called, it will be done by cooling. It is called condensation. Okay, next one, conversion of liquid into solid. When will be it done? Conversion of liquid into solid by cooling. The conversion of a liquid into solid by cooling is called freezing. Okay, now try to match this. Solid to liquid, melting. Solid to gas, sublimation. Gas to liquid, condensation. Liquid to solid, freezing. Check it once. Okay, this is the correct matching. Next, assertion reason type questions. See the assertion given. Some sugar can be added to a glass full of water without causing an overflow. Yes, if you take a glass full of water and if you add a spoon of sugar very slowly, there will be no overflow of water after adding sugar also. Yes, it is correct. Because liquids have spaces present between the molecules. Yes, in liquids, molecules are loosely packed. So they have certain gaps between these molecules. When they add the sugar into water, the sugar molecules will take the spaces between the liquid molecules so that they are not taking any extra space. So that the water won't overflow. It won't be overflown because it is not taking an extra space here. Sugar is taking, its molecules will occupy the places present between the water molecules. So this is a correct reason. Both are true and it is the correct reason for A. Then what will be correct answer? A and R are true and R explains A. That's correct. Okay. Next one. Analytical approach questions. See the question given here. Look at the Venn diagram. Which of the following can be placed in the place of Z? See, each circle representing one state of matter, solid, liquid and gas. The place which is being in common is mentioned as Z. So, the substance in the place of Z will be existing in these three states at normally. So which of these? It most probably it is water. Water only can exist in these three states at normal conditions also. We can see ice, we can observe water vapor, even normal liquid water also at normal temperatures commonly. So water is being in common in these three states, even at normal temperatures too. Okay, it is water. Next, see here. Three containers X, Y and Z as shown below were filled with water and then left near an open window. See here, three containers are taken X, Y, Z. They are filled with certain water and kept left near an open window. Now, the purpose was to find out whether the exposed surface area of the water affects the rate of evaporation. Okay, here they are trying to find whether the open area or exposed surface area of the liquids will affect the rate of evaporation or not. For this purpose, they have taken three containers, different sized containers. They have taken different the contents of different open surface area. They have taken, they filled them with the water, and these three containers are left near an open window. But this experiment is not failed. What is the reason? Why was the experiment not a fair one to detect whether the open surface area affecting the rate of evaporation or not? What is the reason? If you observe once the diagram clearly, of course the containers are having their open surfaces in the different volume. See, it is having the large open area, it is also having large open area, it is having narrow open area. But if you observe once again, the quantities of liquid taken, the quantities of water taken, they are being different. So, from this all, if you see, the X and Z both are having the same open surface, exposed surface. Now, but the water in X is being less than compared to this. So, water from this will be evaporated faster than this. But both are having the same open area. So, here we are not able to identify whether this exposed surface area is affecting the evaporation or not. So, to know whether this exposed surface area affecting the evaporation or not, we have to take the same quantity of water in all the containers. All the containers with a different surface area, we have to take same quantity of water. Then, from the container in which water evaporated fastly, we can identify easily. So, here the problem is water is taken in different quantities in different containers. Because of this, we cannot identify, we cannot detect the effect of exposed surface area in the rate of evaporation. See where it is mentioned clearly in this. The amount of water in the containers was different. So, this is a problem in this. Okay. Next one. Which of the following water molecules, four water molecules are mentioned here in the liquid container W, X, Y and Z, which can easily escape to form water vapor? So, out of these four, which can escape easily to form water vapor? Say, Y is at bottom, Z and W are in middle, X is on the surface. We know the conversion of water into water vapor at normal temperatures is called evaporation. And one more thing we know here about evaporation. Evaporation is a surface phenomenon. What does it mean, surface phenomenon? It occurs only from the open surface of the liquid or upper surface of the liquid. So, the molecules present on the open surface only, they will start converting into gaseous form. It is surface phenomenon. So, the molecules present on the surface converts first into gaseous state or convert into vapor state. So, first X will be easily escaped into water vapor form. Then, after conversion of these all molecules into vapor, then W will come into water vapor form. And then Z, at last Y. Because this evaporation is surface phenomenon. The molecules present on the surface will first convert into gaseous form or water vapor form. So, it is X is correct answer. Okay, because evaporation is surface phenomenon. Okay, thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel AIIMS Today for latest updates on recorded videos. Thank you.